It is the dawn of another quiet morning. And this morning at 7 o'clock, President Jose P. Laurel, accompanied by members of his cabinet, kneeled in prayer before the altar of Malacanang Chapel. The Philippine Republic was born in the very midst of a world at war. Since then, 1 year has passed. 1 year of difficult reconstruction. 1 year of fervent sacrifice for the sake of the youthful nation. Thus were great footprints of nation building left on the annals of Philippine history. Late in the afternoon, a colorful ceremony celebrating the anniversary was held on the grounds of Malacanang. Bearing the marks of 1 year of tireless struggle in guiding the nation, President Laurel, with firm and steady strides, appeared at the grandstand. Last year today, President Laurel stood in the limelight of the world as the first president of the independent Philippine Republic. For the countless heroes and martyrs who shed their blood to break the iron chains of 4 centuries of oppression, silent prayers are offered. After that, President Laurel then expressed the firm and unswerving policy of his administration.
Ika-14 ng Oktubre, taong 1943, isang taong singkat, buhat noon hanggang ngayon, nanaitayo natin ang bagong Republika ng Pilipinas sa hirap na ito na dinaranas ng ating bayan. Nahanda ako na magpatuloy sa daang makikita ninyo na aking inilalagda sa pamamagitan ng tulong ng aking mga kasamahan sa pamahalaan upang tunay maging wagas, maging dalisay sa gitna ng isang digmaang ngayon idinadaos sa isang sinuko, sa gitna ng kaguduan, sa gitna ng kamatayan, sapagkat ang kamatayan may matamis, katulad ng tinuro ng ating mga bayari, kung iya ay magbubunga ng isang pag-asa at ng isang adahikain, pinagpakamatayan niya.
Meanwhile, in the city of Manila, Filipino citizens sponsored various celebration activities. Among those received most enthusiastically by citizens was the personal appearance of stage and screen stars. Leaflets distributed by these beautiful stars pass into the hands of onlookers. Favorite poems and songs by Liwayway Arceo, Norma Blanca Flor, and Corazon Noble brought enthusiastic applause from citizens who recalled the boundless joy of independence gained 1 year ago. Again on the morning of October 15th. A hit-and-run raid, the enemy tried to cover the disastrous defeat suffered by its vaunted Task Force 58 in the waters east of Taiwan. Battered and bewildered by the fierce day and night attacks of the Japanese air units, the 58th Task Force is in desperate straits, trying vainly to limp away from the scene of battle. To cover this retreat, a part of the badly decimated enemy task force appeared in the waters east of the Philippines. Taking advantage of this opportunity, the Japanese Army and Navy Air Forces spread their wings to meet the enemy in joint operation. In skillful and effective interception, Nippon air and ground units blasted more than 30 enemy ship-borne Grumman, bomber, and fighter planes out of the sky. At the same time, other Nippon air units went their way far out to sea and in a surprise attack, either sank or heavily damaged 5 enemy aircraft carriers. Numerous enemy crew members were instantaneously swallowed up in the Pacific graveyard of American ships and planes. The enemy task force, squirming about in the waters east of Taiwan, was, as the Americans have been boasting to the world, the largest aircraft carrier warrior fleet in the Pacific war front. The recent enemy operation, however, turned out just as the Japanese wished. Showdown battle in the Pacific has taken place. In conjunction with the Air Force, the silent Japanese Navy, which had patiently waited this opportune moment, suddenly struck out against the main force of the enemy. In continuous fierce attacks, mortal blows were dealt the enemy. Results show every sign of becoming even greater. This brilliant war achievement of the Japanese forces, appearing in the form of accurate Daihonei announcements, was swiftly relayed to Manila. Extras flooded the streets of the city, and Manila citizens found relief and satisfaction in the mounting war results achieved by the Imperial Japanese forces.